In this emerging world of computers, it has become an essential skill that we understand and speak its language. But the question is which one? So in the spirit of helping you make a decision, we are going to discuss about the same. Hey guys, welcome back to yet another interesting video by Intellipaat. And today we are going to discuss about the top 5 programming languages to go for in 2020. Before we proceed forward, do subscribe to Intellipaat's YouTube channel so that you never miss out on any of our upcoming videos. Now let's have a look at the agenda for today's video. First, I'll give you a brief introduction of what the programming language is and its relevance with regards to its features. To further understand the value of each language, we'll go through its syntax with an example program and look into the major companies that have adopted it. Afterwards, we'll discuss its community strength and the current job prospects. And finally, we'll wrap up the video with some conclusions based on our observation. We'll also have a short quiz at the end of the video, so make sure you put down your answers in the comment section below. Also guys, if you're looking for courses in training technologies, then do check out Intellipaat.com. Alright, now without any further ado, let's get started.
So guys, we're going to start from the very bottom, that is from the fifth number. So on the fifth number, we have the Go language. So first, let us understand what exactly is Go language. What is Go language? So created at Google by Robert Gresmer, Rob Pike and Ken Thompson, Go is statically typed, compiled and open source programming language, which is being actively used in Google programs. Despite the fact that it is a relatively young programming language launched in 2009, it has gained a wide audience much because of the reputation of its parent company. Now let us understand why Google adopted it. So when we talk about its features, so guys, Go was developed for ease of handling large code bases with efficiency and scalability in mind. Let us look at some of its key features now. One of the biggest features of Go is its ability to generate binaries for applications with built-in dependencies. Go gives you access to its powerful library through its packages, and Go provides you first-class support for concurrency at the language level itself. Like I said before, it is a statically typed programming language, which basically means that the type checking is performed before the code is run. The language design is simple and easy to understand. So as we have discussed the features, now let us move forward and look at its syntax with a simple example of Hello World program. So guys, the code that you see on your screen seems fairly simple, but as we move on, we can compare it with other languages. Now let's see which all major companies are using Go language in their products. So companies that have adopted Go are so on: Google, Uber, Twitch, Dailymotion and Fabric, and the list goes on. A large community of users contributes to a lot of the development of any programming language, right? So guys, when we talk about the Go language community, so there are around 100k repositories available on GitHub for Go language itself. So when we look into the job prospects, so according to Indeed, there are around 2100 job listings seeking a Go language developer with an average salary of around $135k per annum. Now guys, moving on to number 4 on our list, which is the C#. C# is a general purpose multi-paradigm object-oriented programming language and is a hybrid of C and C++ and was developed at Microsoft by Anders Helsberg and his team. C# is syntactically similar to Java and is easy to understand for developers with knowledge of C, C++ or Java. Now moving on to its features, so guys, let us understand why C# has been gaining popularity recently. So C# is easy to understand and learn. It is purely object oriented, meaning it treats everything inside program as an object, right? It supports a variety of modern features such as automatic garbage collection, and for a variety of new language, it has got a large community of users. So now when we consider the same Hello World program in C#, so guys, this time, this is how your program looks like, right? In the code, system is a namespace that contains commonly used types, right? A class called program is declared next. Then we use the write line method of the console class to print the hello world. Now let's move forward and discuss about the major companies which have adopted C#. So the companies like Microsoft, Stack Overflow, Intuit, Peridosia, right? So these type of companies has adopted C#, and this list keeps on going on, right? It does not end up here. So like, C# has got large number of community, plus the number of users out there are tremendous, right? So being in use for a long period of time than Go language, C# has more users as well. So guys, when we talk about its community, so there are around 400k C# repositories available on GitHub itself, right? Now when we talk about the job prospects, so according to Indeed, there are around 5000 jobs for C# developer itself with an average salary of around $65k per annum. Seems interesting. Now guys, let us check out the language on the third number of our list, that is the C++. So guys, C++ was developed by Bjarne Stroustrup as an extension to the C language, right? It is a general purpose object-oriented programming language and is one of the most popular languages that is being largely used in game development, system or application software, web development, and the list goes on, right?
A quick info guys, Intellipaat provides certification training courses for all the major technologies out there. So make sure you do check out Intellipaat.com for more information. Let's get back to our session now.
So guys, now let's look at the features of C++ that let it stay on top over the years, right? So C++ is object-oriented and supports all its features. It is simple to understand and powerful with a variety of data types, functions, control statements, etc. It is fast and efficient and has a structured approach also, right? Now let's look at the syntax of C++ here with an example of Hello World again. So guys, you all must be familiar with this code right here, which is shown on your screen of C++ Hello World program, right? Whether you are in college or you're a student or you are in the industry professional, right? You must all be familiar with this code right here of C++, where the code for the problem uses a main function in which the statement to print Hello World is written, right? And the return zero statement is used to return the value from the function itself. So yeah, that's how the syntax for your C++ goes on, right? Now let's move forward and discuss the major type of companies known to have built their foundations on C++. Let's take a look over here. So the companies like Microsoft, Oracle, Mozilla, PayPal, LinkedIn are just few of the names, right? So there are like a lot of companies, like there are like hundreds of thousands of companies who are still using C++ as a primary language in their companies, right? So even when we talk about its community, there are like 530k plus C++ repositories available on GitHub, right? And guys, C++ has been one of the most sought after skills by employers for many years. However, let's have a look at the current scenario where when we talk about the job prospects. So guys, according to Indeed, there are around 4,000 job listings seeking a C++ developer with an average salary of around $116k per annum, right? So now guys, let's move forward. So guys, can you guess which language is on the second position in the list? You might have guessed it right. So that is the Java programming language. This name we have all been familiar with for a long time, right? Seeing it in mobile games as well as web pages. So let us understand what exactly is Java. Developed by Sun Microsystems and released in 1995, Java is a class-based object-oriented general-purpose programming language. It is a compiled programming language, but rather than compile straight to executable machine code, it compiles to an intermediate binary form called JVM bytecode. The bytecode is then compiled or interpreted to run the program. A large number of websites and applications work on Java currently. It derives a lot of its syntax from C and C++ programming languages only, right? Now guys, when we talk about its features, so Java is secure, simple and powerful. It is a platform independent programming language and a multi-threaded feature allows it to run multiple tasks simultaneously, right? Now guys, let's take the same example as before and use Java now. So you can see how is the program for Hello World over here. In the code, classes JFrame and JLabel are imported in the beginning, right? Inside the main function, a new frame is created and the text Hello World is added to it, right? It is a pretty long code compared to all new ones saw before, right? Isn't it? Now let's take a look at the companies operating with Java. So companies like Airbnb, eBay, Infosys, TCS, Wipro, and again, the list goes on. There are like 100,000 plus amount of companies which are currently using Java as a primary language, guys. And no doubt, Java users account to be one of the biggest communities on GitHub also. So when we talk about the GitHub community, there are around 1.21 million Java repositories available on GitHub only, guys. That's a huge amount, don't you think so? So there has always been a huge demand for Java developers. The current scenario remains the same. So when we talk about the job prospects, guys, so according to Indeed, there are around 23,000 job listings seeking a Java developer with an average salary of around $69k per annum, right? So I believe, guys, this should be enough of the reasons to go for Java programming language, right? So guys, now reaching towards our first runner-up here. So guys, I am assuming that you must have guessed it by now that who is the winner over here? Who is on number one? Of course, the most trending language, that is the Python language right here, right? So created by Guru von Rossum and released in 1991, Python is a high-level general-purpose programming language and gives a support to multiple programming paradigms that include object-oriented, procedural, and function programming also, guys, right? And guys, this is one of the most popular programming language, or I would say trending programming language, which has gained a lot of popularity in the past decade, right? And in the past decade also, there are like so many users of Python, and even the companies are using Python, and people are, and we talk about the users. So guys, Python is being widely used currently. It has got like majority, like vast amount of applications in the current industry, be it web development, be it scripting, be it machine learning, artificial intelligence, and even the game development. It has got like vast amount of opportunities for you once you have gained your hand over Python, right? So right guys, when we talk about its features, so it can handle big data and solve complex mathematical equations. It is a cross-platform language also, right? And guys, its English-like syntax makes it very easy to learn for you. Its efficient syntax allows developers to write complex codes in few lines only. Coming to our favorite example, let's check its syntax. So guys, this is the program for Hello World. And guys, it is so easy to execute and implement also. It is just like writing a single sentence on a console, right? Print Hello World, right? And similarly, if you will see the arithmetic operations on Python, that goes the same way, like you are, you know, using a calculator. So like 3 + 4 = 7, you just have to type it and the result will be shown in your screen, right? 3 - 4 = -1. So you don't need to declare any variables. You can simply and you can directly make the arithmetic operations on Python. You can also declare the variables, but without even declaring the variables, you can do so, right guys? Yep. And again, it is that simple. However, being simple does not make it not powerful enough. In this age of big data, guys, Python is the most widely used programming language in data science, as I said before, right? Now guys, let's take a look at the companies which are using Python currently. The list I'm showing you like 5 numbers here. It has got like 100 or thousands of companies out there, be it startups, be it large scale or small scale companies, right? Be MNCs, like everyone is using Python currently, right? So companies like Instagram, Spotify, Facebook, Amazon, Netflix are currently using Python only, right? So this is just a small list over here, guys. So like Amazon, Microsoft, each and every company is currently using Python as a primary language, guys, like in any of their tasks, I would say. And guys, as I said earlier, the number of Python users have increased greatly over the years, mostly because of its ease of learning. So when we talk about its community, there are around 1.17 million Python repositories available on GitHub, guys. That is a huge amount, guys. So like this much amount of users of Python, so that means you will get more amount of help from the community itself. Suppose, and guys, the larger the community or the users are, the larger the problem will arise, larger the solutions you will get, right? So that comes out to be very helpful, being a Python user, right guys? So even guys, when we talk about the job prospects, so guys, a Python developer is certainly one of the most paid in the industry, with job openings coming up every day, right? And according to Indeed, there are around 10,000 job listings seeking a Python developer with an average salary of around $123,000 per annum. And guys, I believe this has illustrated the better career scope for the Python programmers in the near future. I believe I've given you enough reasons to go for all of these programming languages, and especially for Python, guys, right? Now guys, let us conclude our debate by discussing which one you should choose, right? So you guys went through the 5 most popular and trending languages to go for in 2020. All the 5 programming languages mentioned in the video have got their own pros and cons, as we discussed, right? And Go language by Google and C# by Microsoft have been gaining a lot of popularity recently. So Go language, though it is a statically typed compiled language, it is fast enough that it gives you the feeling of a dynamically typed interpreted language, and its high performance has made it strong emerging competitor to the other well-known languages, right? C++, though its demand has been reducing over the past few years, is still a skill that everyone pursuing an education or career in computer science should have, as it also makes it easier to learn the other languages like C#, Java, and Python. But considering the current market trends and demands, Python and Java developers do have a certain edge in the industry. Those languages have been around for a long time, and because of that, a lot of companies are built on them. Right guys, Python, because of its simplicity and efficiency in syntax and large number of libraries, is a really good choice for the field of data science, machine learning, and artificial intelligence. I still advise you guys to go through each of these languages, understand what domain you want to work in, and finally choose a language that you feel you can excel in. Because ultimately, if you're an expert in any of these languages, you will surely have a brighter career ahead, right? So now guys, let me conclude out this video for you by asking a quiz. So which programming language generates binaries with all dependencies built in, right? So the first option that we have here is Go language, second one is C++, third one Python, and the last one is Java. You can let us know your answers in the comment section below to know if you're correct.
A quick info guys, Intellipaat provides certification training courses for all the major technologies out there. So make sure you do check out Intellipaat.com for more information. I hope this video was helpful to you. If you have any further queries, do let us know in the comment section below. We'll reach out to you immediately. Also guys, thank you very much for watching this video and giving us your precious time.